Hello everyone, how are you doing? So we're back for the deck project part 2, and apologies, this did take a long time to put out. I've been doing my own priorities, I've also been testing ideas when I had a chance, doing research on the ideas, on what they relate on other decks that use it better. I've been also researching the meta, trying to understand how these cards can work together. And this is what I have so far. In the earlier video, I did say I was going to split into two projects. However, it just wasn't working out. Excuse me. It just wasn't working out. So I decided to put it together in one deck. Sorry for those of you who were looking forward to it. But anyway, we're going to go ahead and look at the comments you guys left in the last video. So it's not listed here. I don't know why. I guess it's just a YouTube problem. But Kakashi Kyle left a comment basically saying, you need to run 3 super transformations with 3 Hanzos because you want to draw into them rather than searching out through Hanzo. And at first I was against it, but now I completely agree. Valor really hurts, and MST is always a thing. So it's basically like, oh, you Valor my Hanzo, I have one in hand, haha! I summon Hanzo, I search out, set 2 super transformations, the MST one, haha, I got another one. So I really like that. Next we have Illunats TR, sorry I butchered your name. His comment reads, try mass change with Hero Ocean, throw in 3 mass hero acids. Well, that's just my idea of creative. Now, I like the idea, I just wish there was more mass hero monsters. I want a dark mass hero. We've been wanting it for such a long time, us Destiny Hero fans. It'd be really helpful. But other than using Ocean, it's better to use Ice Edge, just because it could chain block our mass hero acids on their summon. So yeah, if you guys don't really understand why, here's a video. Okay, so we're back, and we have Devin Rickert. His comment reads, the Hanzo Super Trans idea is great. By adding Summoner Monk, you can special Hanzo, go into rank 4s like Evil Swarm Nightmare, and then search for a ninja such as Upstart Go Ninja. Therefore, running Breakthrough Skill works. I like this idea, but as I said earlier, Effect Negation is a thing. And, you know, I'm not saying, okay, Effect Negation, OP, let's run normal monsters, no. What I mean by this is that once you get hit with a Vader on these high risk, high reward cards like Summoner Monk and Dark Greffer, it really hurts. But you know, the reason we're gonna run Dark Greffer is because, you know, we want to set up our Greffer, malicious, we want to set up our graveyard as fast as possible. So I kind of don't mind running Dark Greffer. But the difference here is that Dark Greffer isn't as limited as Summoner Monk. To spells, you know, we do have some spells, but most of them are cards that are really important to us. Very rarely are they dead. Other than, you know, like a dead malicious in hand, you know. So I don't feel comfortable running Summoner Monk or Upstart Go to Ninja, but if you guys think that we should run more high risk, high reward cards, that'll leave up to your guys' hands. Just remember, I do want to try and make these decks local ready, if it's possible regional ready, but first off we're gonna try shoot for local, baby steps first. So let me know what you guys think, if we should go for more high risk high reward cards, if you think that's how we should run the deck. Now next we have Still Cruisin. His idea reads, you could also try 2 Gen X Undine, 2 Gen X controllers as another engine. Drawing the controllers does suck though. You can use Undine to drop Dragoons, Atlantean, and also Tidal. Can also lure the controllers away, dump them with Dark Greffer, and synchro into the new level 9 synchro for anything. You can also use cards such as Rogeki Break to dump controllers and Malicious. You can try 3 Malicious and 2 Destiny Draws. Now, I did try Undine Veils at first, I wasn't a big fan, but I decided to go ahead and look at it again because Still Cruisin suggested it, and I said, you know, it couldn't hurt to try again. And I've been doing previous research on Atlanteans not Atlanteans, but the Mermail thread, and how a lot of them are for the Ulin builds just because they're more consistent. And you know, I was like, I was sketchy at first just because the first time I tried it, it didn't really work out. But this time around, I really do like the Undine build. I'm going with 3-2, just like a majority of people, not using 2-2, like still cruising. I did try 2-2, I just could not jump to my Undines faster than my genetic controllers, unfortunately. I do kind of want to try 3-3 ratio later on, but 3-2 is what I'm using right now. And the thing about I love about Undine is that upon her summon, I get deck thinned by 2 or 3 cards, and I either plus 1 or plus 2 off her effect. So I love that about Undine. Undine, we're going to use you for now. D.Va, you can take a backseat. I just wish there was more we could do other than, you know, just summon Undine and pass turn. But, you know, we'll come up with something eventually. Next we, I still have to go over this. The 3 Malicious and 2 Destiny draws. I really tried to remake the Destiny Challenge again, but alas, another year, another failure. I think it's time to give up and wait until we get more support, because this is not working out. But I'll go over my thoughts on the Destiny Hero Engine. You guys can give me your feedback on that as well. So next we have Omega Wolf Yaki. His suggestion reads, 1 Rescue Rabbit and 2 Sea Serpent Warrior of Darkness is what he runs. And now, I like it, but you need to go more in depth with it. You know, what happens if you're drawn to the normal monsters? That's the biggest thing. That's the biggest problem. I mean, you know, Genetic Controller, you know, when we draw into it, you know, at least we can use it as synchro fodder, or we can alert away or dark refer away, you know. But a Sea Serpent Warrior Darkness, what do we do when we draw into it? Could you please go more in depth with your idea, please? Next we have That Little Piece of Steak, and his comment reads, maybe Monk can get Armageddonite, Zephyros, Hanzo, but then you should run another ninja to use Hanzo's effect, and will make you able to go for Level Chain, which you don't run for some reason. Also, Ice Age is a thing, works with Miracle, level 3, triggers Atlanteans, and can pop back rows. Now, we went over the Ice Age thing, I went over the Monk thing. Now, I just need to go over why I don't run the Volvo Chain. The reason is because sometimes you just set up so fast, the Volvo Chain just becomes one of those cards just sitting in your extra deck. You're like, I'm never going to go into you now that I set up my graveyard, why do I have you in my extra deck, kind of thing. So, that's the reason why I don't run it. I don't know if that's poor reasoning or not, but that's just how it's always been for me. But yeah, so anyway, we're gonna go over the deck list. So we have the standard Destiny Hero engine of Doomlord, Diamond Dude, 3 Malicious, Plague Spreader, 3 Hanzos, 3 Undines, 2 Controllers, 1 D.Va, 2 Heavy Infantry, 3 Marksmen, Dragoons, Tidal, Double MST, Foolish, Rota, Triple D-Draw, Allure, Duality, Double Miracle, Warning, Compulse, Double Raigeki, 3 Super Transformations. Extra deck doesn't matter at this point. We're trying to focus on the main build first, and then we can start messing with the extra deck and start getting more creative rather than just sticking to the boring standard stuff. But the reason I think the Destiny Draw Engine may be the way to go instead of a Greffer engine would have to be that we have inherent consistency through the deck, and we can just, it's just better to, it just makes Destiny Draw more consistent. You know, we basically, in what Crow Crystal likes to always say, we have 6 Strausses. We have 3 Hanzos and 3 Undines. Now, you know, we always wait for Strauss to come back, but, you know, we can't wait any longer. We have to try work with what we can. Our deck keeps getting hit, we need to make the best of what we can do. So 3 Hanzo of course gets your super transformations, 3 Undines of course pops cards or searches, whatever. Either way, you're searching and popping at the same time. So we have inherent consistency through that way, which does make Dusty Draw much more live, and in return it does make it easier to draw into Deep Sea D.Va. So that's why I think maybe the Dusty Draw build may be better. If you guys think we should, you know, we have enough consistency and we should go for the Turbo Dark Greffer Malicious Plague Spreader Wombo combo thing and drop the D draws completely, then we can do that as well. But for those of you who had more experience in this format, let me know what's better. Should we go for a draw route, or should we go for a synchro route? I mean, we still have the synchro route regardless, but should we drop the draw power for it? And put in more cards to protect ourselves, like Trigodia, or maybe even more trap cards? Or should we still stick through the draw engine just because we want to cycle through our deck faster? Tell me what you guys think about the deck I've put together so far through your guys' suggestions. And if you guys have any more suggestions, let me know. If you guys think that this is a terrible idea, let me know as well. We can always refix the deck. After all, we're remaking Zero, and rebuilding a deck together is not easy. You know, everyone has their own opinions, but whatever works will work. I don't know what I'm going on from there, but basically, if we can work together, we can find our Zero build before next format, hopefully. So, until then, see you guys.